Hello and welcome to News Review from BBC Learning English. I'm Rob and joining me today is Neil. Hello, Neil.
Hi, Rob. Hello, everybody. We've got an interesting story about space exploration and its future today. The company SpaceX and NASA have been working together. Astronauts have returned from the International Space Station by splashing down into the ocean. And that's the first time people have returned to Earth from space in that manner for 45 years.
And don't forget, you can test yourself on the vocabulary that we're talking about today on our website at bbclearningenglish.com, where you'll find a quiz. Okay, now it's time to find out what was going on in the control room when the astronauts landed.
We have visual confirmation for splashdown.
SpaceX copies and concurs. We see splashdown and mains cut.
Dragon Endeavour has returned home. NASA astronauts
and
Bob Endeavour, and Doug.
On behalf of the SpaceX and NASA teams, welcome back to planet Earth, and thanks for flying SpaceX.
Okay, so we heard there the control room with NASA astronauts splashing down into the ocean after a trip to the International Space Station. They went on a commercial operator into space, and normally they go up with NASA rockets. This time, they paid SpaceX, a company, to provide that rocket for them. And experts are saying this is a real game changer for space exploration because it's the way that it's going to happen in the future.
Yeah, it's an interesting story. And we've got three words and expressions that you can learn about to help you talk about this story, haven't we, Neil?
We have. We have plummeting, starstruck and prank.
That's plummeting, starstruck and prank. OK, should we start with your first headline?
Yeah, the first headline is from the Business Insider website and it reads, new video shows SpaceX's astronaut crew plummeting through Earth's atmosphere, floating under parachutes and landing in the ocean.
So that's plummeting, falling quickly and suddenly.
Yes, plummeting, spelt P-L-U-M-M-E-T-I-N-G.
Sounds like a very dramatic word, doesn't it?
Yes, and I think that's the key. You know, people might say, well, why can't I just say falling? Because it means falling. But plummeting has that sense of falling rapidly and suddenly.
So if I was to go for a walk down the street and I trip over on the pavement, would I be plummeting down to the ground?
No, not really. Unless you wanted to sound really kind of dramatic, or you wanted to say in a kind of comedic way, a funny way, that you were very, very tall and you had to fall a distance. But actually, we wouldn't use it for that. It would be more to describe something like, for example, maybe you are on the Eiffel Tower in Paris and you're leaning over the edge, you've got a water bottle, it slips from your hand. Now that water bottle is going to plummet down to Earth. It's going to hit the ground hard and it's going to travel very quickly and it would have happened very suddenly. And that's what plummeting is.
Sounds very dangerous actually if you're travelling at such a speed as well.
Absolutely, that actually happened to me. Fortunately it didn't hit me. I was standing on the ground outside the Eiffel Tower and a bottle landed right next to me and it could only have come from the top of the Eiffel Tower. It plummeted. That bottle plummeted towards Earth and just missed me.
Thank goodness. So you can be here today to present this programme.
Thanks.
And there's quite a literal use to this word plummeting, isn't there?
It is, yes. But we often hear it used in a more sort of figurative sense and especially in connection with the world of business. So we might hear about share prices, for example, that fall dramatically and suddenly. We might hear share prices plummeting or the value of a currency or particularly at the moment with the coronavirus and the fact that people aren't shopping and things like that as normal, sales have plummeted over the last few months and it has really badly affected the world economy.
That's right. And also I noticed I went into London this week for the first time and there weren't so many people around. There were fewer visitors because visitor numbers have plummeted because people can't travel anymore, I suppose.
Absolutely. The number of tourists has plummeted, and it's made a very strange summer here in the Northern Hemisphere anyway.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, well, let's have a look at a summary of that word. Okay, Neil, let's have a look at your second headline.
Second headline comes from the WCAX.com website, and the headline reads, Starstruck, SpaceX Dragon splashes down Mars mission.
Okay, so that's Starstruck. Describe someone who admires famous people greatly.
Yes, we have a two-word expression here. Star is the first word, S-T-A-R. The second word is struck, S-T-R-U-C-K. Usually, this has a hyphen, but it does not have a hyphen in this headline.
Okay, well, I was starstruck today when I came in and found out that I was presenting with you, Neil.
Oh, yes. Are you suggesting that I'm famous, Rob? Because
yes, I am.
Because I had it exactly the same feeling. And in fact, I have that feeling right now. You are so incredibly famous that I have this feeling of admiration for you.
Okay, slightly so intimidating. We're equally starstruck.
Slightly intimidating me.
We are joking, of course. There are more famous people who we get starstruck about, aren't there?
Yes, you may not believe it, but there are even more famous people than me and Rob in the world. And you have met one of the most famous people in the world, Rob.
Yes, that's Paul McCartney. Sir Paul McCartney from the Beatles, who I met a few years ago. I got a chance to interview him. I was so starstruck that I almost forgot the questions that I was supposed to ask him. And I must also say that he wasn't starstruck when he met me.
He would be if he met you now.
Maybe. But it is that admiration, isn't it, for somebody famous?
Yeah.
Somebody you really kind of have a lot of admiration. You really admire the things they've done.
Absolutely. It's a bit weird in this title, though, isn't it?
Yes, that's true. This headline has got nothing to do with famous people, really, has it?
No, it hasn't. And this is, you know, as people who watch News Review regularly will know, headline writers love a little joke with words, and that's what we have here. Because starstruck, as we've been discussing, is about that feeling you get when you you meet someone or you see someone incredibly famous. This story is not about meeting somebody famous, but it is about space, and so the word star is relevant. So they just put this expression in as a little joke, really.
We might be starstruck if we met a famous astronaut, maybe.
Yeah, if you met a famous astronaut or the astronauts from this space flight, you might be starstruck. You might be starstruck if you met Elon Musk, who is the owner of SpaceX and an incredibly famous and rich man.
Indeed. Okay, well let's have a look at a summary of starstruck. If you like stories about space exploration, we have a great story for you, haven't we, Neil?
We do. We've got a story about SpaceX, which we did a while ago on News Review, about the time when they put a reused or reusable rocket into space. You can find the link to that program down below.
Okay, let's have a look at our next headline.
Our next headline is from the Mail Online website, and it is Space Dads Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken make prank calls in SpaceX's Dragon capsule following splashdown in Gulf of Mexico.
Okay, so the word is prank. That's joke, trick.
Yes, prank, spelt P-R-A-N-K. Here used as an adjective, a prank call. It describes the type of call. What's a prank call, Rob?
Well, it's a phone call you make to somebody to make a fool of them, really, and make them look stupid.
Yeah, so it's a call you make to someone as a joke. You might, for example, pretend to be a person that you are not, or you might make a claim or say something that isn't true in order to make the other person, to deceive the other person, to make a joke on the other person.
And I know all about prank phone calls, don't I, Neil?
Yes, is it time to share with everyone the prank call I made about a year ago to you?
I think you should.
Yeah, So, some of you may be aware that Rob does like a biscuit or two. And we may have mentioned that on News Review in the past, once or twice. And the fact is that one day I thought that I would tell Rob in a prank call that we had ordered a huge pallet full of biscuits to the office in order to get him to come in early, because the truth is that Rob, he's not really an early riser, so we tried to get him into the office. But what happened when you got in, Rob?
Well, I mean, it worked. I did get in early, and I got there, and there was nothing to be seen. No box of biscuits.
You realised that we had pranked you.
Yeah, I had been pranked.
Absolutely. There, you can see we're using it as a verb. So we have it in the headline there as an adjective, a prank call. But we can say that you prank someone, or that someone has been pranked. Or you can even say to play a prank on someone. That's the structure, to play a prank on someone. And we played a prank on you, didn't we, Rob?
Yes, and this is quite a big prank. I wasn't very happy, but to be honest, pranks are generally quite harmless, aren't they? They're a bit of fun.
The intention is that they are harmless. Sometimes they can go horribly wrong, of course, but the intention is that they are light-hearted.
Not this time, Neil.
I'm sorry.
I've forgiven you now. Okay, let's have a summary of the word prank. Okay, so Neil, could you recap today's vocabulary, please?
Absolutely. We had plummeting, falling quickly and suddenly. Starstruck, describes someone who admires famous people greatly. And prank, joke, trick.
And don't forget, you can test yourself on today's vocabulary by going to our website at bbclearningenglish.com, where there is a quiz. And don't forget that BBC Learning English is all over social media as well. OK, Neil, thanks very much for joining us today. And thanks to everybody for watching. Bye for now.
Goodbye.